Hello, everyone. I'm very happy to be presenting today. I'm Eugenio Verrina, and I'm a postdoc at the GATT in Lyon. And today we'll talk about joint work with Zvonimir Bašić on personal norms and not only social norms shape economic behavior. So our starting point for this project is the observation that social norms have been used to explain a very wide variety of behavior across many settings, from pro-sociality to costly punishment, wage negotiations, all the way to political behavior. However, people may not only care about social norms, but they may also care about personal norms. So while both are prescriptions of appropriate behavior, hence moral and correct behavior, they're different because they come from different sources. So social norms capture prescriptions that come from society, while personal norms come from within an individual. So why is it interesting and important to look at social norms and personal norms? Well, because they can differ in many important contexts. So think of tax compliance, discrimination, climate change, and virtually any behavior that is governed by norms. So what can happen is that people may face two potentially competing normative principles, and both can determine behavior. So what we do in this study is we propose a simple utility framework in which we argue that people, in addition to social norms and monetary payoffs, also care about personal norms. And then we design a two-part experiment to estimate this framework and investigate the relevance of personal norms across different economic games and settings. So before I go into the experimental design, let me very briefly talk about the social and personal norm-dependent utility framework that we propose in the paper. So what we say is very simply that the utility of an individual I from performing action AK is given by the monetary payoff attached to that action plus two symmetric components, a social norm component and a personal norm component. And what we're going to do is we're going to estimate the weights that people put on these different components. So our experimental design is rather straightforward. We have a two-part experiment, a first online session in which we elicit social norms and personal norms for four different games, and then a second session, which takes place in the lab. So subjects come to the lab approximately 4 weeks after the online session, and they play the four games. We have two between subject treatments, a private treatment and a social treatment, the aim of which is that of increasing the salience of social norms. So our first result is kind of a conditio sine qua non of our whole exercise. So what we want to know is what the relationship between personal and social norm looks like. So while we do find a considerable correlation between the two, we also find a substantial individual level heterogeneity. So a non-zero difference in approximately 50% of the actions across the games. So what you can see here are the four different games and each action within the games. And what we show is the difference between the personal and the social norm rating, which is zero if it takes this yellowish color, and it's either negative or positive if it takes these red colors or these green bluish colors. So having established this first result, we now want to look at kind of the main hypothesis of our study, namely whether personal norms are explanatory of economic behavior. So we estimate the weights that people put on the different components, and we find that the weight that people put on the personal norm component is always positive and highly significant for all four games and also for our pooled data set. Now, the next step is that of looking at the effect of the social treatment. So we are mainly interested in the interaction between the treatment and the weight that people put on social norms. We find that this weight increases as we predicted for 2 out of 4 games and also for the pooled data set. Interestingly, the weight that people put on personal norms remains unaltered. Now, the last step of our main analysis is that of looking at the added value of personal norms. So we want to know and we want to compare a two-norm model with a model with either only social norms or only personal norms in it. And what we find is that indeed personal norms increase the predictive fit of our models, and in fact, that the two norms complement each other. We also have a whole series of robustness checks, which you can find in our paper. And the last bit of data that I want to show you comes from additional experiments in which we replicate our very first result for the 4 main games and also extend this result to additional games and vignettes. And that's what you can see down here. Okay, so I'm already concluding. Personal norms are a strong predictor of economic behavior. They complement social norms in doing so and are robust to exogenous manipulation. They are also distinct from social norms across a very wide array of economic context. And we think this builds robust evidence that people do not only care about social norms, but also personal norms. If you want to know more about the paper, you can scan this QR code and you can also find me on Twitter. Thanks a lot.